Hello everyone, welcome to the video on inotropic agents. This is a part of congestive heart failure treatment. In the previous class, I have explained about digoxin or digitalis glycoside, which is used to treat congestive heart failure. The remaining inotropes are beta agonist and phosphodiesterase inhibitors. In this video, we will see about mechanism, indication and adverse effects of these two inotropic agents. This is my YouTube channel. If you like my video content, do subscribe and share. Let's get into the topic. See, positive inotropic agents which will increase cardiac contraction. Their job is to increase the strength of heart muscle contraction, and that results in increased stroke volume and increases cardiac output. The major symptom of congestive heart failure is reduced cardiac output. So to treat this, these positive inotropic agents are used. There are three major classes: cardiac glycosides, beta agonist and phosphodiesterase inhibitors. In the previous class, I have explained about cardiac glycosides, and in this class we'll see about these two agents. Let's get into the topic. Now, to understand how beta agonists act, we need to understand where do they act, what kind of receptors will get affected with this beta agonist. Now look at them. So this is a beta adrenergic receptor. It is a type of G protein coupled receptor, especially it is GS type. So when the beta receptor is activated by a binding of an agonist, it activates adenyl cyclase enzyme. The activated adenyl cyclase converts ATP to cyclic AMP. Now the cyclic AMP activates protein kinase A, which is known as PKA. Now, kinases will phosphorylate the substrate, and substrate for this protein kinase A is voltage sensitive calcium channel. So phosphorylation of this channel results in opening of calcium channel, and calcium entry occurs, and that is what causes increased force of contraction. It binds with myofibrils and increases force of contraction. This is how beta agonist will act. Again, let me brief it out. See, beta adrenergic agonist binds to G protein coupled receptor of type GS. They activate adenylate cyclase, which increases the levels of cyclic AMP. It activates protein kinase A. It phosphorylates calcium channel, and phosphorylation results in opening of calcium channel and increases calcium entry into the heart. And these calcium binds with myofibril and increases force of contraction. One more aspect, the cyclic AMP is metabolized by phosphodiesterase enzymes to AMP. So these agents, phosphodiesterase enzyme inhibitors, inhibit the metabolism of cyclic AMP and increase the levels of cyclic AMP. So the increased levels will activate PKA, it phosphorylates calcium channel, opens the channel and increases the levels of calcium. So both these drugs, phosphodiesterase inhibitors and beta agonist, both of them will be acting on same mechanism. This is an enzyme inhibitor, this is an agonist. So this is what is the mechanism of both the agents. Now let us understand broadly about all the inotropic agents' action. See, digoxin, it inhibits sodium potassium pump, that inhibits sodium calcium exchanger, so the calcium levels inside the heart are increased because of digitalis. Now, next one, dobutamine is a beta agonist which binds with beta receptor, increases the levels of cyclic AMP, which phosphorylates calcium channel, again increases the levels of calcium. Now, the next one, phosphodiesterase enzyme inhibitors like enamrenone, mildrenone inhibits this enzyme, inhibits the metabolism and increases cyclic AMP, which phosphorylates calcium channel and again increases calcium level. All these increased levels of calcium increases the release of calcium from sarcoplasmic reticulum, so there is high levels of released pool of calcium, and that is what binds with troponin and tropomyosin and causes contraction. The same thing is explained in a different manner. See, all catecholamines like beta agonist bind with this GS kind of receptor, activates adenyl cyclase, increases cyclic AMP level, which activates protein kinase A, that phosphorylates calcium channel, releases calcium, which acts on this ryanodine receptor of sarcoplasmic reticulum and releases more amount of calcium. It causes contraction. Now, cyclic AMP is metabolized by phosphodiesterase. When you inhibit that enzyme, again cyclic AMP levels increases. Finally, calcium levels are increased and causes contraction. Cardiac glycosides inhibit sodium potassium pump, that also inhibits sodium calcium exchanger, increases levels of calcium, that is what results in cardiac contraction. So all of them, the basic job is to increase the levels of calcium, and that is what increases cardiac output. Now let us see the details of phosphodiesterase. Phosphodiesterase inhibitors like enamrenone and milrinone, they are used to treat acute congestive heart failure. They increase cardiac cyclic AMP. If you remember, cyclic AMP is metabolized by phosphodiesterase. You inhibit this enzyme, cyclic AMP levels are increased, and it results in positive inotropy, increased force of contraction and increased cardiac output. There is another feature is there with phosphodiesterase inhibitors. In smooth muscles, increased cyclic AMP causes relaxation and decreases total peripheral resistance. In another sense, it causes a kind of vasodilation. Now understand these aspects. See, both beta-1, beta-2 receptors belong to GS type of G protein coupled receptors. But beta-1 increases cardiac contraction, beta-2 causes smooth muscle relaxation or vasodilation. So the same GS, increase in cyclic AMP, in the heart increases cardiac output, in smooth muscle causes vasodilation. So the same thing, phosphodiesterase enzyme inhibitors, they increases inotropy as well as they also causes vasodilation. Hence they are known as enodilators. So they will show inotropic agent action as well as vasodilation action. Look at this, they inhibit this enzyme, increases cyclic AMP and GMP, and they cause increased levels of calcium. Increases calcium and in the heart, so this results in increased cardiac output, whereas in the blood vessel it causes vasodilation. So that's why they are known as enodilators. Now there are some subfamilies of phosphodiesterases are there, like PDE5 is specially used to treat erectile dysfunction and pulmonary hypertension, whereas PDE4 is used to treat pulmonary diseases and inflammatory conditions. PDE3, this is specific to cardiac tissue, which is used to treat myocardial infarction and intermittent claudication. Non-specific ones are used to treat pulmonary diseases, lung diseases. Now the side effects, see, everywhere the common side effect is headache. Increased blood vasodilation, increased blood supply to the head is what results in headache. The remaining thing, nasal congestion, understand this one. Vasoconstriction treats nasal congestion. Alpha-1 agonists are very popular decongestants. Why? Because they cause vasoconstriction. But if vasodilation is there, that results in nasal congestion. Now the remaining thing, dyspepsia, flushing and priapism are the common side effects of PDE5 inhibitors. PDE4, nausea, diarrhea along with headache. PDE3, it may cause ventricular arrhythmias and hypotension. Vasodilation results in hypotension. Now let us understand these agents. See, beta agonist, very popularly used one are dopamine and dobutamine. They activate beta-1 receptor. But they increase cardiac energy consumption and they increase the risk of arrhythmia. Why? Beta agonists are positive inotropic agents as well as positive chronotropic agents. Heart rate is increased as well as cardiac output is increased. Increase in heart rate increases energy demand. That may result in arrhythmia. This is what is the advantage in digitalase. Digitalase reduces energy demand but increases cardiac output. Now, enoxaparin, milrinone, PDE3-4 inhibitors, they increase cellular cyclic AMP. The important thing is they increase cardiac output and dilate blood vessel. Hence, they are known as enodilators. So these are all the major features of all these drugs. Mostly they are used to treat pulmonary arterial resistance. So this is about the remaining enodilators. Thank you for watching this video. If you like the video, do subscribe and share.